space is big. You know this. It's very big. It's so big, science fiction authors open fake guides to traveling through space by talking about how big space is. But that means that there's a lot of room to fit stuff in it. Very big stuff. And in March 2025, a paper published in the journal Astronomy and Astrophysics announced that astronomers had found the biggest thing ever. It is so big, it breaks the laws of physics as we know them. This is Kipu, a superstructure roughly 1.4 billion light years across. It stole the record of biggest thing in the known universe from another superstructure called the Sloan Great Wall, which is 1.37 billion light years across, and so named because it looked like a big wall in a map of the universe. Kipu, meanwhile, shares its name with the Incan record-keeping tool that involves making bundles of cords with knots, because that's what the superstructure shape kind of looks like. Well, that and it was discovered with data from Chilean telescopes. Kipu contains hundreds of thousands of times the mass in the whole Milky Way galaxy, or alternatively, because astronomers love to measure mass relative to our sun, over 200 quadrillion solar masses. But as big as Kipu is, I must admit, it isn't really like a single thing, nor is any other superstructure. They're more like an organizational unit. So say a galaxy is a building on the island of Manhattan in New York City. That would make the island of Manhattan a galaxy cluster and the whole of New York City a supercluster. A superstructure would be like the tri-state area, which takes New York City and lumps it in with parts of Long Island, New Jersey, Connecticut, and more. So if you want to argue that a superstructure can't be a biggest thing because it's too many individual things, I get it. That's fine. You be you. We'll be us, though. Because, like, individual galaxies are also a collection of much, much smaller things bound together by cosmic forces. And even something that pretty much everyone can agree on as being a single thing, like a star, is a bunch of particles held together by cosmic forces. But setting semantics aside, because who needs that, how do astronomers actually map the universe to find these gigantic structures? We are in the universe. Don't know if you know that. But that makes it pretty hard to map. Almost like we're trying to figure out the size and shape of a pancake while we are a chocolate chip inside a pancake. Surveys like the Sloan Digital Sky Survey, which found the Sloan Great Wall, take really thorough images of the whole sky to determine the distances to hundreds of thousands of galaxies. Those distances, combined with the positions we see objects in the night sky, are enough to make a 3D map of the universe around us. And armed with that map, plus knowledge of the laws of physics, scientists can calculate which galaxies are close enough to interact with each other via gravity, linking them together into one of these superstructures. The research team that found Kipu used a whole bunch of data, like high-energy X-rays from galaxy clusters and existing infrared maps of the universe, to try and identify as many superstructures as they could. In total, they saw 5 superstructures, 4 of which were already known, but they also found Kipu. But let's get back to the whole so big it breaks physics idea. Oh wait, actually, there's an ad coming in, real quick. Do you ever put off a task that you know is gonna be tedious, so you just ignore it and hope it goes away? Yeah, that's how I was with budgeting, until I got some help from Rocket Money. Rocket Money is an all-in-one personal finance app that helps you cancel subscriptions, lower bills, and manage your money better. Like, when I linked all of my accounts to their app, which was not difficult to do, Rocket Money found and categorized all of my subscriptions, which helped me see where my money was going every month. They also caught a few that I didn't know I still had, and they even helped me cancel them. Their app lets you look at all your finances in one convenient place, create a budget based on your actual spending habits, and even help you set some realistic goals for saving some money. And who doesn't like saving money? To take control of your finances today, go to rocketmoney.com/scishow to get started for free. The universe's structure is often described as a cosmic web where there are clusters of galaxies with lots of matter and great voids where there's barely anything. But on very large scales, like superstructure-sized big, the universe should theoretically look the same everywhere. This is known as the cosmological principle. And the cosmological principle basically tells us 2 things. One, the universe is homogeneous. There's no special places in the universe. Like, there's no such thing as the center of the universe, unless everywhere is the center of the universe. And two, the universe is isotropic. No matter which direction we look at in the night sky, it should look just about the same. In astrophysics, lots of calculations depend on the cosmological principle, like, say, figuring out how fast the universe is expanding. So it's pretty important to know if this principle is actually true. But if the cosmological principle only applies on very, very large scales, what exactly counts as large enough? It turns out scientists don't quite agree when you get down to the nitty-gritty, but generally, the universe should look uniformly smooth-ish beyond scales of around 1.2 billion light-years. At 1.4 billion light-years long, Kipu is just a bit too long. And so are other structures, like the Great Sloan Wall or the Giant Arc, which is more than 3 billion light-years long, but isn't as massive as Kipu. Meanwhile, our own galaxy seems to be sitting in a 2 billion light-year wide void that's 20% less dense than an average chunk of the universe. These all appear to be violations of the cosmological principle, and as the years pass, astronomers keep finding more and more of them. So how true can this fundamental assumption about the universe possibly be? Some researchers claim we merely have to reconsider the scale at which the cosmological principle applies. If you zoom out far enough, lower the resolution of your view of the universe, everything will smooth out. But what if we just have to keep zooming out? Like, is there a point where we should just cut our losses? Hopefully before we reach the size of the observable universe, right? I mean, do not ask me this question. My degree is in biochemistry. So I do not know. It also could be our observations that are off. To map the universe, astronomers rely almost entirely on observing bright galaxies, but we know some matter is less luminous, or even invisible, so we may not be seeing the whole picture. And at least in Kipu's case, it's not 100% clear if all the clusters inside of it are really bound together by gravity. Some may break off in the future, in which case it's not as massive as astronomers are currently estimating. But that still leaves every other problematic data point on the corkboard. So, what if these superstructures, like Kipu, really do break physics? Other than having to update a bunch of textbooks and forcing students to skip eating to buy those new textbooks, the ripple effects through cosmology could be huge. Any calculations that assume the cosmological principle is true, which again, a lot of cosmology does, will have to crunch the numbers all over again. That might not always be a bad thing, though. For example, there's an outstanding problem in cosmology about just how fast the universe is expanding. Basically, the rate predicted by our current laws of physics doesn't match our actual observations. But superstructures like Kipu, and the motions of the galaxies within them, could change the value of the constant in our equations that describe the expansion of the universe. It'd only be by a few percent, but it's enough to maybe make a difference in this cosmological crisis. So while all the experts keep sciencing, and I trust them to come to us when they figure new things out, I'm just gonna keep an eye out for the next big thing in the universe. Literally.